Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, I want to talk to you about if and when you should take a shorter exam, and how to make the longer 7+ hour exam fit that new 5:45 timeline. The first question to consider is, should you even bother with a shorter exam? Why not just take them all at 7+ hours? When I was in the Navy, we had a PRT or fitness test twice a year. This included a 1.5 mile run back when I dreaded and hated running. As I practiced and got to the point of being able to run 1.5 miles, that really meant being able to run 1.25 miles, dying for that last 1/4 mile, and just collapsing at the end. But that's not how you want to finish a military test. So what I did instead was I practiced for 2 miles. Running for 2 miles meant struggling for 1.5 miles, squeaking out that next 1/4 mile, and barely surviving that last 1/4. But you know what? My endurance got to the point where I could run 1.5 miles just uncomfortably, but to be able to finish in the required time. And then my endurance would break down to the point where I couldn't really run the full 2 miles, but I aced 1.5 miles. And that was until I found out that you can swim for the PRT, and I love swimming, which is why I stopped running in the Navy. When it comes to an exam like the MCAT, a 5:45 hour exam or longer, it requires a lot of endurance. It's a lot like running even a marathon, right? People run a marathon in 3 hours. This is a 7.5 hour exam. So my argument is, unless you're in the final weeks going into your MCAT, do you even want to be taking a 5:45 exam? Or wouldn't you be better off to say, I'm a beginner, my endurance sucks, I'm gonna practice, I'm gonna take the 7+ hour exam, and I'm gonna struggle with it, and that's okay, because then when I take the shorter exam, it's gonna feel like a piece of cake, because I've done a 7-hour exam. If you don't wanna sit through such a long exam, that's fine. A lot of third-party companies have already revised their exams, like Next Step, Altius, Kaplan, to 5 hours and 45 minutes, giving you the new simulated testing conditions. You can save 10% off the Next Step Blueprint exams using the discount code linked on my MCAT resources page below. This means phases 1 and 2, it's not a problem. But those are third-party exams. And the closer you get to your MCAT, the closer you get to the real thing, the more you want to practice exclusively with AAMC materials. And the AAMC exams are still 7+ hours. I have 3 options for you to consider based on how much time you have, how tedious you want it to be, and how accurate you want the scores to be. The first is very simple. Take a 7+ hour exam. Yes, it's longer, but you know what? If your endurance is up here and the real exam is down here, you'll be fine. The only difference I recommend here is that instead of taking the allotted 30-minute break, cut that down to about 12 minutes. Why 12 minutes? The current exam has a 10-minute lunch break, and knowing that you're going to sit for over an hour beyond the 5:45 exam, those extra 2 minutes gives you a chance to just recover, refresh, and build up your endurance for the second half of the exam. If you're saying, I don't want to sit a 7-hour exam, I want to sit exactly 5 hours and 45 minutes because this is what the new MCAT is like for this year and I want to simulate testing conditions perfectly, we have option number 2. This one's a little tricky to follow, so bear with me. What you're going to do is start that exam as if you're taking it for 5 hours and 45 minutes, but you're going to watch the clock very carefully, because the shorter MCAT gives you only 48 questions per section, 76 minutes for the sciences, and 81 for cars. So work your way through the chem phys section until question 48, which should end at 76 minutes, and then end the section. Yes, you're going to leave all those questions unanswered, hang on, but end the section, your section is done. Take your 10-minute break, do the same thing for cars, 48 questions, 81 minutes. When you get to 48 and 81 minutes, don't finish till 90, even though the full exam goes that way. End the section. You have your lunch break. It's set to 30 minutes. After 10 minutes, that's it. Your break is over. You're going into bio-biochem. We do the same thing and for psych-soch. When you score your exam, you're going to be a little bit disappointed because if you stopped at 48 questions, that means everything after that you got wrong because you left them out and your score is going to be lower. That is okay for now. Your day is over. Your exam is over. Don't even look at the score. Go do something fun. Go watch a movie. Hang out with your family. Have a virtual hangout with your friends. And go to sleep. Relax. Tomorrow morning, when you're mentally recovered, here's the tedious part. This is what you're going to do. Open the exam as if you're going to review and mark down all of your answers. You want to know exactly what you chose for question 1, 2, 3, all the way to 48 for every section of the exam. This is very tedious, but this is the most accurate method I can come up with for getting a realistic score. After you have it all written down, take the exam again as if you're starting from scratch. You have multiple tries, so this is attempt 2. And what you're going to do, question 1, look at your answer from yesterday, add that in. Question 2, what did I choose yesterday? Add that in. So you're copying yesterday's answers onto this new exam until you get to question 48. Then you ask yourself, under realistic testing conditions, how much time would I be allowed for the remaining questions? For science passages, that's 8 minutes. Cars passages, 10 minutes. Science discrete, 1 minute. That's how I like to break it up. And take the rest of the exam under realistic conditions. If you do this for all of the sections, then by the time you're done, this round 2, everything that you did yesterday is already done. Anything you didn't get to yesterday, you just did now under realistic conditions. Maybe you were more refreshed, a little sharper, maybe you scored a little bit better. But for the most part, yesterday was under MCAT time conditions. Today is just the remaining passages under MCAT conditions. Then you score your exam. Whatever score you get, this is where you assume you are. This is what you put into your calendar. This is what you use to evaluate your readiness. This is the most accurate and most tedious method that I can come up with for taking the exam under 5 hours and 45 minutes. But if you're OCD like me and you have to have your data exactly as you need it, this might be the way to go. But if you're thinking, okay, this is way too much work, Leah. I just want to take the exam and have an idea of where I am. There's option number 3. For option 3, you sit down to the full 7+ hour exam. But like option 2, you're only going for 48 questions in 76 minutes. For the cars section, 81 minutes. Then any questions that remain, you just guess. I don't care if you go ABC, eeny, meeny, miny, mo, whatever. Guess and end the section. Take a 10-minute lunch break. Same thing for bio-biochem. Same thing for psych-soch. And end your exam. The situation here is that even though you did answer all the questions, if you guess them right, they contribute to your scores. But if your guessing is less accurate than your ability to answer questions, you're going to lose points. But instead of doing that whole tedious next day process like option 2, I want you to do some math instead. Look at the first 48 questions and calculate the percent correct in that part of the exam compared to the percent correct when you guessed. For example, let's say you got 80% of the first 48 questions correct, but you only got 5 out of the last 11. At 80%, you should have gotten about 9 out of 11. That means 4 questions that you got wrong, you would have gotten right if you took it under test conditions. If the discrepancy is 3 to 5 questions, just add a point to your score. Even though the score isn't going to be too accurate here, you're going to be close enough, and it's a lot less work than the previous option where you kind of have to redo the entire exam. So let's say you're looking at the percent correct. You calculate the difference and you see, okay, so I have a 124 in the chem-phys section. I missed 4 questions. My score is estimated at a 125. Say you do the same thing for cars. You realize that you have a 126 and your difference in guessing is only 2 questions. You probably don't want to add another point because 2 questions may not have bumped the score. But if you're at a 126, mentally you can think, I'm either at a 126 or a 127. Now, this seems a little wishy-washy, but it still gives you the ballpark of where you are. Going back to my initial question, should you be testing with a shorter exam? I'm going to argue that early on, it won't hurt to go longer. But if you want to go shorter, a lot of the third-party companies already accommodate that. As you get to phase 3 and you want to get more and more accurate, closer to the real thing, you can still go for the longer exam to practice extra endurance. You can take just the first 48 questions, score your exam, re-enter and finish the next day for a proper score, or you can take the first 48, guess on the rest, and add a point to any section where you anticipate you would have gotten at least 3 to 5 more questions correct. Now, taking this into practice, first, make sure you give this video a thumbs up and subscribe so that you don't miss out on any new videos. And then let me know in the comments below, are you going to practice with a shorter exam? And if so, what option are you going to use? And more importantly, why?